Hello, this is Danica and I build WordPress membership sites. And there's this task that I'm working on. It's a very simple one actually and a quick one, but I want to share it with you. It's using GamingPress and I have also integrated it with Jet Engine and the dynamic visibility to be specific. Because this website, I did not build this, so it's using GamingPress. ACF, and there is just certain stuff that the client asked me for help. And again, let me just show that with you. So let me just shrink my face smaller here. So if we go here, as you can see, so they have the certain activities that they want their students to finish. Now, example here, if this is the certain activity, what they want is when they collect their badge, we redirect them to a specific section in the dashboard where they could easily see the badge that they have claimed for. So let me show you what I mean. So example, if I collect this badge and then I'm redirected to this specific section. And if you're gonna check out the URL of the page, it has some anchor link. So what I've done is, first is I have edited, this is using Elementor, so I've edited the section and I added an ID. So let me just open the Elementor page builder to show you exactly where I inserted that. Let's just wait for this to load. So at the bottom part in this section, advanced, so there is this class ID toolkit. I hope you could see it. Maybe my recorder is blocking it, but it says class ID and then toolkit, and that's what you saw here. Now let me just run another example to give you another one. So this is for the My Heart section and they have certain activities inside this as well. So example here, if I claim this badge, I'm gonna be redirected to that specific section in the dashboard. So this one, it doesn't have a content yet, but I just added this collect your badge button to run this. And by the way, I also created some redirect or loading indicator to show so that the member is not wondering why it's taking too long to load the page. And also, I am dynamically inserting the title and the featured image. So it's different and it's gonna follow based on that page. Let me just show you what I mean. So if I collect this badge, it's gonna very very quick, but as you can see, this is the same with this, and it says collecting your badge for being kind to myself. I hope that you capture that one, but that's dynamic. I have a video for that. You could check out GamingPress, my GamingPress video that I recently uploaded. I showed how I built that exactly. So, and again, when I click the collect your badge, then because that activity is under the My Heart category, then I am redirected to this section. So how exactly did we build that? Let's just check the template that I have created. So example, if I'm gonna go to the toolkit again, and then here, brainstorm tips. Okay, so here, collect your badge. If we check out the templates, we have this mark complete button. And by the way, if you have any question with GamingPress, you could comment that down below and I'm gonna answer that as soon as I can. Also, you could check out my other videos regarding GamingPress. I have uploaded 2 videos recently before this one, so check those out. But again, feel free to fire your questions in the comment section. So as you can see, I have 4 complete your badge button. And this one, this is actually pulling some value in the ACF field, but I have wrapped this in a shortcode, and then each button is for the toolkit. This is for the My Heart, and then My Story, My Impact. You could also track, because I have kind of followed their branding color, so whichever chapter they are, that button is for, I followed. So this is for the toolkit, so that's the button for the toolkit. This is for the My Heart, and then that's the button for the My Heart. But each of this has a unique redirect line. So in here it says set timeout, and then we have this anchor for the toolkit. So I hope I could paste that here. Not sure. Maybe I can. I'm just gonna drag text so that you could see. But the shortcode is this one. So class redirecting on click, and then it's really this redirect link. So we have this hashtag toolkit part. So let me just remove this because we don't need that here. But each of this button has those specific anchor link attached to it, and that's how it points or redirect the students properly to the right section when they collect their badge. Now, as you can see, this is four buttons, but when I visit, like example, the being kind to myself part, so if I visit this, you will see that it's only showing this one button, which is specifically this one. Now, I have used the Jet Engine functionality dynamic visibility for widget to make this work. So first is you need to install Jet Engine, and then go to the Jet Engine part. Let me just refresh. I think I need to refresh. Okay, Jet Engine here, and then this one, dynamic visibility for widgets. So that's the one that I enable, and then after that I have edited this template. This is the template for the button, and in the advanced tab there is this dynamic visibility part. So in here it says I'm not sure if you could see this properly. Let me just zoom in. Okay, so in here it says dynamic visibility enable, yes, visibility condition type show element if condition is meet. Now you need to set specific condition based on how you need it. Now for this button, I need it to show only if specifically show the button on specific chapters. So what I created is show element if the condition is met. So it says contains, because you could, there's a bunch of rules in here. So if it contains the post term, I'm using the chapters for the taxonomy, and then in here toolkit, then show this button. Now if I'm going to click the other one, so it's gonna be different, of course. Dynamic visibility contains My Heart. So again, that's how this dynamic visibility from Jet Engine works, and I hope this video helps. So basically that's what I've done. You just need to make sure, like when you're building this sort of gamification, you need to sit and think how exactly you need it to work first before jumping in and purchasing what plugins you need to use. But if you're looking for a dynamic functionality, it's really one of the best choices, either CrocoBlock, because they have this package where you could get several advanced features like this. And if you're using ACF, you can just also get Jet Engine alone. You can just grab the license for that single plugin, or else you could get their full package. But again, in this example, I enable jet engine and I enable the dynamic visibility for the widget functionality to make this work. But the value from the more complete button is actually using ACF custom fields. So, and it still works and there's no conflict and stuff. So, I know there may be some questions that you'd like to ask. Again, fire that down in the comment section, and I hope this video helps, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.